Hi everyone, this is Mr. Zoller, and today I'm going to be presenting you a screencast on the Emancipation Proclamation. So our goal for today's video is that you, as a student, can describe the reasons for the issuing of what's called the Emancipation Proclamation, and then analyze its immediate and long-term impact. So looking at the Emancipation Proclamation, so at the heart of the nation's bloody struggle during the Civil War were millions of enslaved African Americans. Abolitionists urged President Lincoln to free them. In an 1858 speech, he declares, this is before he's president, "There is no reason in the world why the Negro is not entitled to all the natural rights enumerated in the Declaration of Independence, the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness." Yet as president, Lincoln found emancipation, or the freeing of slaves, to be a difficult issue. He did not believe that he had the constitutional power. He also worried about the effects of emancipation. So he believed that only the Congress and the states could declare slaves to be free. So if slaves were freed, why might that frighten northern factory workers? Well, the big reason would be if you have free African Americans that were slaves that didn't get paid at all and now have a chance of taking factory jobs and getting paid less, that might cause some problems. And then emancipation would be unpopular in the United States if Lincoln couldn't figure out a way to convince the Americans that, hey, this is something that we could really do. So he needed a big Union victory to prove that, hey, the United States could possibly win the Civil War against the South and that the promise of freeing the slaves might come to pass. So for several weeks in 1862, Lincoln worked intensely thinking, writing, and rewriting. He finally wrote the Emancipation Proclamation, the order to free the Confederate slaves. So not the Union slaves, but the Confederate slaves. The proclamation declared that all persons held as slaves within any state or designated part of a state, the people whereof shall then be in rebellion against the United States, shall be then thenceforward and forever free. So the Emancipation Proclamation was a military order that freed slaves only in areas controlled by the Confederacy. The proclamation thus had little immediate effect. It was impossible for the federal government to enforce the proclamation in the areas where it actually applied, the states in rebellion that were not under federal control. The proclamation did not stop slavery in the border states, which had stayed loyal to the Union. The words written in the Emancipation Proclamation were powerful, but the impact of the document was more symbolic than real. So Lincoln wanted to be in a strong position in the war before announcing his plan. The Battle of Antietam gave him the victory he needed. He issued the Emancipation Proclamation on September 22, 1862, and then the proclamation went into effect on the new year, on January 1, 1863. So this is going to be a military order saying that all slaves in the Confederacy are free. Of course, how's the Union going to carry that out? They're not in control of the Confederacy. But this is a promise saying that as the Union moves through the Confederate states, slaves would be freed on their way. And this also proclaims that now the Civil War isn't just a war to unite the country again, but it is also a war to end slavery. But Lincoln did make sure to keep slavery in the border states here that are part of the Union. So you can see here for the border states, we have Missouri and Kentucky, Delaware and Maryland that remain loyal to the Union, even though they had slavery. And then by 1863, West Virginia had broken off and become a state, and even though they used to be a part of the Confederacy. But now they're going to be a border state once they break off. So here's a picture kind of the Emancipation Proclamation. So remember, emancipate or emancipation means to be freed from bondage, to be freed from slavery. And African Americans in the Union are going to be enthusiastic about this, that now there's going to be, in the Civil War is now a war to end slavery, not just to reunite the southern states.